When did you first realize you were an oracle? And do you feel guilty for being a siren in your past life?
Ooh, the oracle is from the past life, and no, I like taking sailors' lives.
How did you feel before level 1 and 2, and how do you feel now after finishing?
Well, I think before level 1, I just wanted to make people have an energetic experience. It felt like being an energy worker and a Reiki master for almost 11 years, I wanted to have a visual, tangible, visceral effect when I am able to channel energy through me. And what I've realized now is that's actually not the point. And that the point is really for someone to be in their most peaceful, blissful, embodied experience, to remove the trauma. And maybe not so much to remove the trauma, but to welcome it so much so that it becomes a part of the pleasure. And now after level 1 and level 2 training, I have realized that I know nothing and I feel everything. I came to Kundalini bodywork with expectations to find a deeper part of myself that maybe I did not have access to before, a deeper part that I had been hiding from, something that had been escaping me, something that I was not able to surrender to. And my expectations were Hiroshima'd. They were blown to smithereens, dissolved, the cosmic orbit ate them. And it was everything I needed and so much more. And so I leave this testimonial for anybody who is desiring for the more, for the magic, for the mundane to be transformed, for the pain to be pleasure, for the ineffable to land in your body, in every layer of your auric field, and for you to understand that it's all here. It always has been. And that the being and the becoming is the entire journey. And I'm very grateful to Elliot, to this level 2 in Denmark, this group of immeasurable human beings that have reminded me of my soul and my soul connections and everything in between.